नमस्ते, आई नितिका चटवाल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, सेकेंड ईयर फार्मास्यूटिकल साइंसेस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ विमेंस यूनिवर्सिटी, इज हेयर टू डिलीवर द लेक्चर ऑन कोलॉइडल डिस्पर्जन विच इज इन फिजिकल फार्मास्यूटिक्स सेकेंड. ओके, एज वी प्रीवियसली डिस्कस द टॉपिक अबाउट वॉट आर द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ कोलॉइडल डिस्पर्जन, देन वी स्टार्ट नाउ वॉट आर द properties of colloids. This is the continuation of previous lecture, which is in colloidal dispersion. Now we start what are the properties. Now properties of colloids are classified in three types. First one is optical properties, second one is kinetic properties, third one is electronic or electrical properties. In optical properties, first one is spindle effect, second one is ultra microscopy, third one is electron microscopy, and the fourth one is light scattering moment. In kinetic properties, it is shown by Brownian moment, diffusion, osmotic pressure, viscosity, and sedimentation. And the last one is electrical properties, which are measured by electrophoresis, electroosmosis, Donnan membrane effect, and the last one is electrical double layer effect. Now, first one is optical properties. In optical properties, we firstly see or study Tyndall effect. What is Tyndall effect? It was first observed by John Tyndall in 1869. When a beam of light is passed through a colloidal solution, the path of light gets illuminated, and this illuminated path is called as what? Tyndall cone. Now, this Tyndall cone is measured, and this light is measured, which is known as Tyndall effect. The intensity of the scattered light is related to the difference between the refractive indices of the dispersed phase and the dispersion medium. True solution do not show Tyndall effect because the solute molecule or ions are so small in structure. If they are in so small structure, they do not show scattering of light. As we know, in true solution, if we pass a light through that true solution, there is no scattering and the light will not show its effect. Hence, a true solution and colloidal solution can be distinguished on the basis of Tyndall effect. For example, twinkling of stars and blue color of the sea and sky, tails of comets, they are the examples of what? Colloidal system, because in this light shows its color, okay, or light scattering is visible. Now the second one is, as we studied Tyndall effect, the other one is ultra microscopy. How we know it is colloidal dispersion? We do ultra microscopy, which is also known as dark field microscopy, when a cell containing colloidal dispersion is viewed through a ultra microscope against dark background at night, at right angles to an intense beam of incident light, the particle will appear as the bright spots against the dark background can be observed and counted. Ultra microscope is used in microscope electrophoresis technique for the measurement of particle charge. And in electron microscopy, that is the different technique. And in this, main feature is its high revealing power or high resolving power. The electron microscope is useful to get pictures of actual particles. It helps in the study of particles, size, shape, and structure of colloidal particles. And other technique is light scattering. When a beam of light is passed through a colloidal dispersion, some lights get absorbed or some light gets scattered and remaining is transmitted. Absorbed light imparts color to some colloid. For example, gold particles absorb deep red color lights, silver particles absorb brown color lights, and silver iodide particles absorb yellow color lights. scattered light results in turbidity of the colloidal dispersion, which can be calculated from intensity of scattered light. The formula for this is I equals to I naught E minus Cl. That is the turbidity of colloidal dispersion that can be measured by this formula, where I is equals to intensity of transmitted light, I naught is intensity of incident beam, L is length of the sample tube, and tau is turbidity. Turbidity also used to determine the molecular weight of the colloid by using the following equation, and that equation is Hc upon tau equals to 1 upon m plus 2bc, where H equals to optical constant for a particular system, and where C is concentration of solute in gram per centimeter cube of solution, where tau is turbidity and m is molecular weight and B is interaction constant. How we measure the scattering light with the help of estimation of the particle size, shape and interaction of dissolved macromolecules, we measure the scattering light. That is useful in determining size of association colloids and the number of surfactant molecules forming them. Also studies the nature of proteins, natural and synthetic molecules or polymers. Now, what are the instruments that are used for the measurement of turbidity? That are spectrophotometer, nephelometer. They both are instruments that are used to measure turbidity. Now, what are the kinetic properties to know about colloidal dispersion? That are, first one is Brownian movement. It was first observed by whom? Robert Brown. In 1827, with pollen grains suspended in water. Firstly, he see pollen grains that are suspended in water. So from there, he started to observe. There are continuous collision between the colloidal particles and the molecule of dispersion medium, which are in constant motion and passes kinetic energy to colloidal particles by striking in form all sides. This results into zigzag movement of colloid particles. Then this particle zigzag movement is known as what? Brownian movement. In Brownian movement, particles move from region of higher concentration to lower concentration. Basically, the movement starts from higher concentration to lower concentration in many cases. The velocity of particles increases with lowering particle size and viscosity. Increasing the viscosity of dispersion medium by adding glycerin or a viscosity thickening agent that will decrease then stop Brownian motion, because in low viscosity Brownian motion can be stuttered, but if the viscosity is higher, then the Brownian motion will stop. Significant. What is the significance of this Brownian motion? It helps in imparting stability to the colloidal soles by enabling them to remain dispersed in the medium and not allowing them to settle down. Then the dispersion is coarse dispersion or the colloidal dispersion. That will be seen by that the dispersion is not get bad or it is in its nature. Because that will allow the particles to remain dispersed in nature. It will not allow them to settle down. Okay. Now, what is the other method? That is diffusion. In diffusion, it is a natural and spontaneous process of transport of ionic, atomic or molecular species across the concentration gradient. Where the concentration gradient goes, diffusion occurs there. For example, Brownian motion results in the diffusion of colloidal particles. However, the rate of diffusion becomes slower due to large size of particles and their slow movement. If a particle is large, then its movement is very much slow. And if a particle is of low size, then it will move very faster. Okay? Diffusion can be described by, with the help of Fick's law. The Fick's law we studied very in a previous lectures and we know what a Speck's law. It states that the particle diffuses from a region of higher concentration to lower concentration until the concentration of the system is uniform throughout the system. Molecular weight of spherical molecule of polymer can be calculated by what? Speck's law. Okay. I think you all know about the Speck's law and the formula of Speck's law, right? Now, the third one is osmotic pressure. Now, what is osmotic pressure? The osmotic pressure, which is denoted by what? Pi, right? Now, of a dilute colloidal solution is described by Van 't Hoff equation. And that equation is pi equals to Cg upon mRT, where pi is osmotic pressure, Cg is gram of solute per liter of solution, m is molecular weight, t is absolute temperature, and r is molar gas constant. Okay, this equation is used to calculate the molecular weight of a colloid in a dilute solution. Now, what is viscosity? Viscosity is the resistance to fluid to flow under an applied stress. Einstein, you know very well about Einstein. Einstein described an equation of flow to dilute colloidal dispersion of spherical particles, which is n equals to n naught 1 plus 2.5 c. n naught, where n naught is viscosity of the dispersion medium and n is what? Viscosity of the dispersion when the volume fraction of colloidal particle present is. According to the Mark-Hornick equation, intrinsic viscosity is used to calculate the molecular weight of polymers, right? Now, what are the factors that affect these properties of colloidal dispersions, right? Now, the factors are, first one is shape. If shape is high or large or small, then the dispersed particles will be in different nature. And if affinity of particles in the medium is of concentration gradient is higher or lower, then it will also alter the colloidal dispersion properties. And what is the type of colloid is present in the system, this will also alter everything. And last one is molecular weight of the particle. If molecular weight is high or low, then this will also alter the dispersion system. Now, fifth one is sedimentation. Brownian motion tends to disturb sedimentation. The rate of sedimentation is given by Stokes' law. As we know all about Stokes' law, we study previously very much about Stokes' law. Now, what are the properties of colloidal particles? Properties of colloidal particles to carry charges on their surface, either by ionization or by adsorption, various techniques are involved in it. First one is electrophoresis. The movement of colloidal particle under the influences of electric field is called as electrophoresis. When an electric field is applied across the colloidal solution, the colloidal particles migrate to oppositely charged electrode where they get neutralized. The phenomenon is known as electrophoresis. The rate of migration of particle is observed by ultramicroscope. The rate of movement of single colloidal particle is directly related to beta potential, right? The migration rate is a fraction of the charge on a particle and related to what? Beta potential, right? Now, osmosis. When electrophoresis of dispersed particle in a colloidal system is prevented by some suitable means, it is observed that the dispersion medium itself begins to move in an electric field. This phenomena is known as electroosmosis. Okay. Now, we study about what are the different applications of colloidal systems or colloidal particles. The first one is facilitate adsorption of ionizable drugs from GIT by using some charged micromolecules that can penetrate into semi-permeable membrane. So, mutual ionic repulsion occurs that retards drug absorption occurs if the drug complexes with the macromolecule. And the other application is, the above equation is useful in calculating the ratio of concentration of diffusion, which I briefly discussed earlier, an ion outside and inside the membrane at equilibrium. Okay. So that's it for this lecture. Thank you so much. And if any queries, you can comment and ask me. Okay. Thank you.